Hello everybody, my name is Denis and you are watching Close to AlgoTrading. Today we have a special video, where I combined all our previous steps to show you how all parts can work together in the real trading. All sources you can find in the GitHub and you can try it by yourself. I will use Interactive Brokers API and one my old project, IbTrader. I have started to work on it many years ago, but never have time to finish it. And now, I am thinking of renewing it again. So, if you get interested in this special project, let me know in comments to this video. Let's quick check what we are going to do today. Very short update and overview of our reinforcement learning environment and agent. Brief introduction to the model deployment with Flask. As we are going to use a Qt application to connect to a broker, we need to use REST API to work with our model. At the end, we will see how all these parts are running together. Before we start, I recommend you watch my earliest video to better understand what is going on here. If you saw my earliest videos, you may already know how to create a reinforcement learning agent using TensorFlow agent library. I made some changes for our agent and environment. The agent is still DQN, the same as we used earlier. But now, we are going to use Q network instead of QRNN network. As I change a bit the agent, I also change the environment. I made it simpler. Instead of many days of historical data, now we have a price observation only for a current day. You may see that the shape of the price is only 5 elements. The position is the same as was earlier. But using the only current observation is not a good idea. We will transform our observation from 1 day to 3 historical days. For that, we can use a history wrapper from the TensorFlow agent environment package. The wrapper adds observation and action history to environment's observation. We set history length parameter to the 3. So, now if we check the environment's observations, we can find that we have 3 of our normal observations. Now, we know what is the shape of our data. And one observation contains the normal open, high, low, close data, plus volume. But to have the similar range, I performed some transformation. So our input data should be log price percentage changes. And finally, as I already told, we need to fit our model with 3 observations. Current day plus 2 history days, and also we have to remember the position state of the past days. After training the agent, we will have a policy that will predict an action, buy, sell, skipped or close. The policy is just normal NN and we can use a direct API to work with it. But what if we don't want to couple our application with the recommendation model, or our model is an ML model implemented in Python, and you want to use it in different applications. As you may remember, I presented a software architecture of the trading system, and one of the points was that we should not pack everything together. The very simple solution will be to deploy our model as a small web service. Here Flask will help us. This solution provides not the best communication speed. But if you don't play as home high-frequency trader, you will find it very useful. What is a Flask? Flask is a micro web framework written in Python. I choose it for this video because it is simple and doesn't need much time to start working with it. And also, we can use JSON to transfer our data from application to the model. So, to debug and deploy our Flask application, we can use the following Dockerfile, which is created in Visual Studio Code. Microsoft has a good tutorial on how to create it. Please check the link in description. You may see that the Dockerfile needs a requirement file, which contains version of Flask and HTTP server. Also, one important moment, your Flask application should be mapped to the name app. In our case, our Flask application has a name app, so we have app-to-app mapping. Then, we just need to build the Dockerfile and run it. But before we do that, let's see how our Flask application looks like. First, we need to import Flask from Flask and create our Flask application object. Here's just an example of how you can link URL routes to functions. The app root line above the function is a decorator. A decorator modifies the function that follows it. A common pattern with decorators is to use them to register functions as callbacks for certain events. In this case, the app root decorator creates an association between the URL given as an argument and the function. In our example, there is a decorator which associates the root URL to this function. This means that when a web browser requests this URL, Flask is going to invoke this function and pass the return value of it back to the browser as a response. In our case, you will get plain text "Hello Flask." Now, let me define the root predict. The method attribute specifies the HTTP request method that should be used. We will use POST request and we will send from application data in JSON format, so that we can easily transform this data and then feed our policy model. The response will be also in JSON format. There is a code that we are going to use to transform data and then pass to the policy. You may already know the following code. First, load a policy, then we have two functions for creating a time step and running the policy. Then we can use these functions to predict our next action. Please check previous video where we created an environment and reinforcement learning agent. The next part of our infrastructure is an application which is connected to the broker, receives data and sends the orders to the server. Actually, we can implement our strategy in application directly, but for this example, we will not do it. Well, you can ask me why we are going to use Qt. The simple answer will be just because some years ago, I thought it would be a good idea to learn Qt and create my own application for algorithmic trading using C++. In addition, Qt is a cross-platform and well-documented. So was born the Qt IbTrader, and I will be using it today for demonstration. Unfortunately, it is still in development because I don't have enough time for it. If someone is interested in work together on this project, let me know. Or just check the code. The link you will find in the description. Okay, let's go back to our topic. Let me say that Qt application is an execution model, and we need to communicate with our strategy, action selection model, using REST API. As you remember, our API has only very simple method predict, where we are going to post input data and receive action back. The input data should be transferred in JSON format, and Qt framework already has classes to work with JSON. Let's check an example. Our input is two simple arrays. JSON format is very similar to Python dictionary. We have keys and values. In our application, we are going to create two QJSON array objects, one for price data and one for position status. Then, to have a complete pair key value, we will create QJSON object and add key price with QValue QJSON array object price and key POS with the value QJSON array object POS. Now, to get the input that we can send to the network, we need to create a QJSON document object and call the method toJSON. This method converts the QJSON document to a byte array. So, every time we will send data to our prediction model and we need to prepare our data. Let's create a very simple class that will describe our input data model. We have here two QJSON arrays and the member that contains the history size. I hope you remember that we need to fit our model with the data of 3 days. And let's check implementation. In the constructor, we will add to our arrays so many zero elements as a history size parameter contains. Also, we have the addObservation method, where we remove the oldest element from our array and add a new one to the end. Now, when preparation of the data is finished, we need to send a request to our model. For that, we are going to use QNetwork Access Manager class. This class allows the application to set network requests and receive replies. QNetwork Access Manager has an asynchronous API, so we need to create a slot for reply reception. We need to create a connection between the manager finish signal and our reply slot. Then we can create a network request and send an HTTP POST request. After the manager finishes the request, we can get data from the response. Very easy, is it? Well, now, when we already know all parts of our system, let's see how it will work together. Let's start our Flask application first. I have started it in the debug mode. So, now we need to remember the port and update it in our Qt application. Now we need to connect to the Interactive Broker application or Interactive Broker Gateway. Before clicking to connect, let's check if the API is activated and we have to correct port. Well, everything is good. We can start our test application, which is using our model. You can see that every 5 seconds we send a request to the server with different price data. Every time when we are getting price data from the broker, we are triggering our model and receiving back the action. So, I hope it was interesting. Subscribe to the channel and see you in the next video. Bye!